rock, hallelujah. Hard rock.
Thank you so much.
You are so welcome, but actually you are way too big for our table, in a way.
Well, not for the table, for the chairs, yes.
He's amazing.
Amazing. I must say, I've never hosted a monster like you before. It's impressive.
Well, clearly because you haven't hosted me before. So
that's true. Was it easy to get through Belgian customs?
It's always easy, you know? Because there's rarely any trouble at the borders or customs or anything with the officials. I just say, and that's enough. Yeah, they let me through.
I see. Mr. Lloydy, shall I introduce you to our other guests?
Yes.
Do you happen to know them?
I do.
Tom Helsen, of course.
We already met in the backstage.
And I know you.
Yeah, I know you too.
Yeah. I know you, but you don't know me.
I know. But
you're in my dreams. You're like,
ooh.
Yeah. Very raw.
Dreams, right?
Yeah. Tom is our Mr. Eurovision, eh? In a way.
Oh.
No, I just hang around here. I don't know much about it, but I'm just here to meet people like you because it doesn't happen very often.
You know what's funny? Because they keep telling me in Finland that I'm Mr. Eurovision. I have no fucking clue about Eurovision.
Mr. Eurovision is Johnny Logan, you know.
I know, but in Finland, I mean.
Finland, okay.
That's the point.
But do you actually know Sandra Kim?
No, oh, absolutely. I do.
Yes.
Do you know my song?
Yeah. I mean.
Can you
quite a few Eurovisions, you know?
It was 32 years ago.
Right.
It sounded like this. It went like this, Mr. Lloydy. How about this? She was only 13 years old.
I'm not the same. Do you recognize me? I don't think so.
I do.
You weren't born yet.
Okay, your hair is different and you don't have a pink dress. So other than that, you look exactly the same.
Thank you.
Right.
Mr. Lloydy, for Belgium, unfortunately, the Eurovision Song Contest is already over since Tuesday. But your country, Finland, is still in the running.
Yeah.
Yeah. They have a song called...
Yeah, did I sound surprised?
Yeah, you did. Because don't you like that song?
No, I do. I actually do like the chorus. You know, I do like the chorus. Uh-huh. I think the chorus is pretty good. And I like the title.
The title is...
It's called Monsters.
Monsters.
Ah, voilà.
And it klinkt zo, dames en heren. And?
It's very difficult to sing like that.
Difficult to sing?
Oh, upside down.
Upside down, yeah. Okay.
It's lacking some electric guitars for my taste, but and it's quite far away from Kiss, from the holy values of Kiss and Twisted Sister, but other than that, it's an alright song.
All right. In ieder geval, ze zit toch maar mooi in de finale. Mr. Lloydy, let's talk about you now. You won the Eurovision Song Contest in 2006.
Yes.
Right? And but you were already famous before that.
Well,
not as
famous, but yeah, we were touring already, and we had some albums out, and we were touring Europe already.
But that victory must have been a game changer, right, for you and your.
I mean, in terms of media exposure, I mean, you cannot buy that with money. I mean, you could have all the money in the world for marketing campaigns at the record labels and shit, but when you do that show. Mm. You are known then across Europe, but actually throughout the world.
You have an 8 year. Brilliant.
I know.
Yes.
I feel pretty.
It's not too warm. Yeah, just a little bit.
Is it not too hot?
Well, I'm a Finn, so I keep my mobile sauna with me all the time. So all the Finns, we have saunas, so, you know, it feels nice and comfy like this.
You wrote a history with your band and in this suit, but your candidacy was fairly controversial.
Oh, it was.
At the time.
It was.
Did that bother you?
No, I mean it's actually for a metal band or rock band, it's all good. I mean, bad publicity for a band like us is good publicity.
I see. So they called you devil worshippers, yeah. and okay, Satanists, and you said, okay, right, good for us.
No, I mean that's never fine. I mean, for example, I come from a really religious family. Mm. Actually, I do.
You do?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
He brought his whole family with him.
I keep my ancestors with me. You know. The thing is that okay, that was quite hurtful because you know people who talk about like Satan worshipping, Satanism, stuff like that, they usually don't have a fucking clue what that means actually. Mm-hmm. And we as a band, we couldn't be more further from anything like that. I mean, this is entertainment. This is art, if you will. Mm-hmm. It's horror, and yeah. It has. I mean. That is almost the same as somebody would claim that all the horror films are for Satan worshiping material, uh-huh. which is not true. Oh, you know, so it is entertainment.
So that did hurt you. That surprises me.
Yeah, I mean, it did. It was kind of like, you know, come on.
And there's something else. When you had won, then people said, oh, that was not thanks to the song, but thanks mm-hmm. to the outfit.
But they were right.
Ah.
But I agree. I agree. Because I think that, you know, it's clear. I mean, let's face it. I mean, we know, and we already knew before we even entered, we knew that, okay, if we have a chance of actually winning the Finnish competition, which we were invited to first, mm-hmm. We said that, okay, we have actually a pretty good chance of making it top five because we already have a lot of fans around Europe and mm-hmm. we will bring our own voters, you know. So... The thing is that I already forgot the question, by the way. but the thing is that
Don't bother.
Never mind.
Questions are not so important.
Ja. Yeah.
Maar het ging over dat het gecontesteerd was, hè, en dat mensen achteraf zeiden dat het is dankzij hun uitrusting en hoe ze eruit zagen. Wat vonden jullie toen? Weet je dat nog? Er was veel rond te doen, hè? Van.
The thing is, there was a guy called Miguel Wils in Belgium. He's a famous piano player. Right. He played your song. And he sang it like with a real singing right. voice, and it was beautiful.
Right.
So yeah. and he said, actually, it's a really good song because yeah. when you put everything away,
I know,
because the melody stays.
Yeah, exactly. Because I'm all about the melody. I am. Mm-hmm. When I write my songs, I always write about I always melody first. The thing is that it is just about the arrangement. I mean, all music is the same. If you take an acoustic guitar or a piano, and you know, all music is there's no genres before it is produced yeah, yeah, a certain yeah, way yeah, and arranged yeah. certain way. You know, I mean, it's like any metal song can be turned into a classical music, or any pop song can be turned into a metal song.
When you walk yeah. over the street, you only sing the melody. There's never instruments, so yeah. it's always yeah. about the melody.
Dan zou Lordi eigenlijk ook J'aime la vie kunnen zingen.
I could, but it would sound pretty weird.
Can you sing my song? No, I don't think so.
Well, I
it's
could,
a bit
but
difficult
it would,
in
it
French.
It would be completely different. Oh, yeah, oui. Not in French.
No, I know. Never mind.
The only thing I know in yeah. French is the laughter.
Mr. Lordi, do you remember the Belgian representative of Eurosong in of the song contest in 2006 when you won? Do you remember that?
Kate Ryan.
Just right. like that. Yeah, bang.
With the knee thingy?
The iconic knee thing?
With the knee? You had a problem with the knee, right?
Yeah. yeah. could, do you think you could do that? That's yeah. it? You can
no,
do it?
Well,
do
that's
it.
My version. I can do it like Iron Man.
yeah. Listen, this suit. Why did you ever decide to perform in this monster outfit?
I've always been a fan of monsters since I was a little kid. I started doing SFX makeup experimenting mm-hmm. with my mom's makeup kits when I was a little, like 7 or 8. And then I'm a huge Kiss fan, Twisted Sister, uh-huh. Alice Cooper, Wasp. So this is just really natural for me. I've always been a fan of okay. bands that have a strong visual image. And, mm-hmm. and for me, this is like my version of my own idols. It's like an updated version of all my idols.
Oh, I don't like that. Oh, I'm afraid. I'm very scared of monsters.
Yeah,
oh no, horror films. It's not yeah. Ooh la la.
I like it. Yeah. I like it a lot. But you have to brush here and you have to brush there and you have to brush. Okay.
Sandra, dan heb ik nog iets van jou. Zijn nieuwe single nog niet gehoord. Zullen we daar eens naar luisteren? Want ja, het toert nog altijd over heel de wereld. Maak nog platen. Nieuwe plaat Sexorcism. En dit is een nieuwe single Naked in My Cellar. Oh. This is not the most women-friendly song ever written, eh? Is it?
It is.
It is?
It is. Uh-huh. It's a love song.
Right.
No.
Love song.
Kind of our way, you know.
And I suppose that in your cellar you keep only tomatoes and carrots.
Sure, sure.
Yes, of course. Nog even iets over die tweede halve finale die eraan komt. De favorieten van vandaag. Peter die had het al even over Whalen. Dat is de Nederlandse inzending. En Whalen, fans. Heleboel fans van Whalen in de zaal. En Whalen die gaat zo. Sandra Kim zegt hier naast mij, yes. J'aime bien. Ja?
Zeer goed nummer. Ja? Egal wat dit stijl of
Thomas, denk jij? Ja, zij is er zot van.
Het roept me helemaal terug naar een tijd dat ik fan was van John Bon Jovi. Ik vind dat heel John Bon Jovi.
Ja, ja, ja,
maar
ja.
Het is goed, hè?
Nou, tof, hè?
Ja,
Mr. Lorry?
Ja. I mean, I'm not kidding. That is my favorite song of the competition this year. Absolutely, it is.
Ik hoop. Ja.
Good, Mr. Lorry, I expected that you would say Hungary is my favorite. This is Hungary. Pretty heavy though.
Yeah, yes. It is metal. It is definitely more metal than anything else before.
Uh-huh.
On Eurovision.
Even more metal than
Oh, well, it is. You can hear it. It's much more metal. But what we were talking about, the melody. Because I'm all about the melody. And this is the... I mean, I respect the guys and I respect the style that they're doing. But that actual song doesn't do it for me. I mean, the genre is like, sure, right, cool, all right, cool. But the song doesn't do it for me.
Fair enough. Mr. Lordy, thank you so much for being with us. It was an honor.
Thank you so much.
Gratitude. Jij ook natuurlijk, hè, Sandra Kim. Bedankt. Het was heel fijn om je hier nog eens te hebben. En Tom, respect. En ook voor jou, hè.
It was nice meeting you. Yeah. It was nice meeting you for the second time.
Yes.
It was nice meeting you for the 23rd time. But...
Yeah. Blijft altijd geweldig, hè. Geweldig om jou hier nog eens te hebben. Bedankt, Tom Helder, dames en heren. En dan is het nu tijd om over te schakelen naar Peter van der Veire in Lissabon.